Making news now at 6 tonight, downtown Springfield is seeing a surge of new apartment buildings, and another one could be on the way. A $50 million apartment building may be coming to downtown. The project would be 5 stories high and have a variety of floor plans. It's called College Town International. It would be built where the old Arbor Hotel location once stood. Color 10's David Chasanoff has more now on why they want to build the apartments there in the first place. David.
David, I spoke with CTI's Dan Weinstein. Weinstein says he wants to improve this low-income part of downtown.
We are interested in areas that have blight, that need to be revitalized. We think there's opportunity there.
Blight is a property that's in bad condition, which makes it qualify as an opportunity zone.
It's a federal tax benefit.
Sarah Kerner of the city of Springfield says the U.S. government allows investments in low-income areas to get tax benefits.
People who have capital gains taxes can make investments in these areas and receive deferment of their capital gains for the amount of time that they leave their money in the investment.
CTI's project is self-financed by lenders. They're requesting a 20-year tax break from Springfield City Council.
I think you have to remember that a lot of projects just simply will not pencil. We're taking a substantial amount of risk.
But Weinstein says it's worth the risk.
Because of the proximity to Missouri State, to Drury, and to OTC, we also like the fact that we're within very close walking distance to, you know, the downtown core.
A tax break would keep CTI from having to pay any new taxes.
Without those type of incentives, it would be very difficult to generate a return on a project of this type.
Springfield would not gain or lose money from that incentive. But Kerner says in 25 years, the city would receive the long-term benefit.
Because, I mean, in 25 years, this thing is still going to be valuable, and they're going to have a big property tax bill to pay, and at that point, you know, we'll get the benefit.
Kerner says removing a vacant lot would make people feel safer. Again, the developer still has to get approval for the tax break.
And now we'll see what the city has to say about that. David, we'll follow it up. Thanks.